Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 10 in Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. We are going to solve problems in the isentropic flow. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the governing equation for isentropic flow in nozzle and diffuser, relationship between various properties in the isentropic flow, effect of area variation in the nozzle and the diffuser, mass flow rate through the nozzle and diffuser, and flow characteristics in the nozzle and diffuser. These are all the topics we have discussed earlier, and we solved a few problems from the anionostic question paper in the isentropic flow. In this lecture also, we continue with the problem solving from anionostic question paper. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the isentropic flow. Example number 6 from May 2010 and May 2013 question paper, a supersonic nozzle expands air from PO stagnation pressure 25 bar and stagnation temperature 1050 Kelvin to an exit pressure of 4.35 bar. The exit area of the nozzle is 100 cm square. Determine throat area, pressure temperature at the throat section, temperature at the exit section, exit velocity as a fraction of maximum attainable velocity, and the mass flow rate. So, we write down the given data. The stagnation pressure PO1 equal to PO2 equal to 25 bar, stagnation temperature TO1 equal to TO2 equal to 1050 Kelvin, P2 equal to 4.35 bar, A2 equal to 100 centimeter square. The pressure ratio at the exit P2 by PO2 equal to 4.35 divided by 25 equal to 0.174. So, from the isentropic table 3.2 page number 33, at P2 by PO2 equal to 0.174 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take M2 equal to 1.8, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.607, A2 by A star equal to 1.439. Now, from the isentropic table again, table number 3.2, page number 31, at Mach number equal to 1, for choking condition, Mach number equal to 1 and gamma equal to 1.4, T star by TO equal to 0.834 and P star by PO equal to 0.528. So, throat area, A star equal to A2 by 1.439 equal to 100 divided by 1.439 equal to 69.49 centimeter square. Pressure and temperature at the throat section, T star equal to 0.834 into TO, which is 0.834 into 1050 equal to 875.7 Kelvin. P star equal to 0.528 into PO, which is 0.528 into 25 equal to 13.2 bar. Temperature to exit, T2 equal to 0.607 into TO2, which is 0.607 into 1050 equal to 637.35 Kelvin. Next, exit velocity as a fraction of maximum attainable velocity, C2 by C maximum equal to C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2 divided by C maximum equal to square root of 2Cp into TO. Substituting numerator 1.8 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 637.35 divided by square root of 2 into 1005 into 1050 equal to 910 divided by 1452.75 equal to 0.627. The mass flow rate, M equal to rho 2 A 2 C 2, which is rho 2 equal to P 2 by R T 2 A 2 into C 2. So, the substituting numerical value is 4.35 into 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 637.35 into area equal to 100 centimeter square, 100 into 10 power minus 4, and C 2 equal to 910.89. So, the mass flow rate equal to 21.66 kilograms per second. The answer to the problem, throat area equal to 69.49 centimeter square, pressure and temperature at the throat section 13.2 bar and 875.7 Kelvin, temperature at the exit equal to 637.35 Kelvin, exit velocity as a fraction of maximum attainable velocity is 0.927 and the mass flow rate equal to 21.66 kilograms per second. Example number 7 from November 2012 question paper, a gas is isentropically expanded from pressure of 10 bar and temperature of 525 degrees Celsius in a nozzle to a pressure of 7.6 bar. If the rate of flow of the gas is 1.5 kilograms per second, determine pressure, temperature and velocity at the nozzle throat and the exit, maximum possible velocity attainable by the gas and the type of the nozzle as its throat and its throat area. You take gamma equal to 1.3 and R equal to 0.464 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. The given data, so PO, stagnation pressure equal to 10 bar and the stagnation temperature is 525 degrees Celsius, which is 798 Kelvin. Pressure P2 equal to 7.6 bar, mass flow rate M equal to 1.5 kilograms per second, R equal to 464 joules per kilogram Kelvin, gamma equal to 1.3. We calculate the pressure ratio to exit, P2 by PO2 equal to 7.6 divided by 10 equal to 0.76. Now, isentropic table 3.1, page number 22, at P2 by PO2 equal to 0.76 and gamma equal to 1.3, we take M2 equal to 0.66 and T2 by TO2 equal to 0.938. So, from isentropic table again, table number 3.1, page number 22, at M star, the stoking condition, M star equal to 1 and gamma equal to 1.3, we take T star by TO equal to 0.87, P star by PO equal to 0.546. Now, the temperature, pressure, temperature and velocity at the throat section, T star equal to 0.87 into TO equal to 0.87 into 798 equal to 694.26 Kelvin and P star equal to 0.546 into PO, which is 0.546 into 10 equal to 5.46 bar. C star velocity at the throat section, C star equal to M star into square root of gamma R T star, so which is 1 into square root of 1.3 into 464 into 694.26 equal to 647.1 meters per second. Density of the gas at the throat section, rho star equal to P star by R into T star, so the value 5.46 into 10 power 5 divided by 464 into 694.26 equal to 1.7 kilograms per metric cube. The area at the throat section A star equal to M by rho star into C star, so 1.5 divided by 1.7 into 647.1 equal to 1.36 in 10 power minus 3 meter square, which is 13.6 centimeter square. The temperature and velocity at the exit section, so T2 equal to 0.938 into TO2 equal to 0.938 into 798 equal to 748.5 Kelvin and C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, so M2 equal to 0.66, square root of gamma is 1.3, R equal to 464 and T2 equal to 748.5. So it is velocity equal to 443.5 meters per second. And density of the gas at the exit, rho 2 equal to P2 by R into T2. So P2 equal to 7.6 into 10 power 5 divided by 464 into 748.5 equal to 2.19 kilograms per meter cube. Then area at the exit, A2 equal to M divided by rho 2 C2. So 1.5 divided by 2.19 into 443.5 equal to 1.54 in 10 power minus 3. Meter square, which is 15.4 centimeter square. The specific heat of the gas Cp equal to R into gamma by gamma minus 1, which is 464 into 1.3 divided by 1.3 minus 1 equal to 2010.7 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And the maximum possible velocity, attainable velocity of the gas Cmax equal to square root of 2 Cp into TO, which is square root of 2 into 2010.7 into 798 equal to 1791.4 meters per second. So, the answer to the problem, pressure, temperature and velocity at the nozzle throat and the exit, P star equal to 5.46 bar, T star equal to 694.26 Kelvin, C star equal to 647.1 meters per second, P2 at the exit, P2 equal to 7.6 bar, T2 equal to 748.5 Kelvin, C2 equal to 443.5 meters per second. Maximum possible velocity attainable by the gas equal to C maximum equal to 1791.4 meters per second. The type of the nozzle and the throat area. It is a convergent nozzle because M2 equal to 0.66 and the throat area equal to 13.6 centimeter square. Exit area equal to 15.4 centimeter square. Example number 8. A convergent nozzle has an exit area of cross section of 10,000 centimeter square, air expands isentropically through the nozzle from the constant inlet condition, PO, stagnation pressure is 5 bar and stagnation temperature is 500 Kelvin to 1 when the Mach number equal to 0.1, exit Mach number is 0.1 and 2 exit Mach number is 0.8. Determine In the above two cases, the exit velocity and the mass flow rate. This is from May 2013 question paper. A2 is given as 1 meter square, 10,000 centimeter square equal to 1 meter square, stagnation pressure PO equal to 5 bar, TO equal to 500 Kelvin. From isentropic table, 3.2, page number 28, at Mach number at exit, M2 equal to 0.1 and gamma equal to 1.4. We take T2 by TO2 equal to 0.998, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.993. So, properties at the exit, T2 equal to 0.998 into TO2, which is 0.998 into 500 equal to 490 Kelvin, P2 equal to 0.993 into PO2 equal to 0.993 into 5 equal to 4.965 bar. Velocity C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, which is 0.1. Into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 490 equal to 44.37 meters per second. Density of the gas at the exit, rho 2 equal to P2 by R into T2, 4.965 into 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 490 equal to 3.53 kilograms per meter cube. So, mass flow rate M equal to rho 2 A2 C2, which is 3.53 into 1 into 44.37 equal to 156.63 kilograms per second. Again, from the isentropic table, 3.2, page number 30, for Mach number at exit, M2 equal to 0.8 and gamma equal to 1.4, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.886 and P2 by PO2 equal to 0.656. So, the properties at the exit, T2 equal to 0.886 into TO2, 0.886 into 500 equal to 443 Kelvin and P2 equal to 0.656 into PO2, which is 0.656 into 5 equal to 3.28 bar. Velocity C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, which is 0.8 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 443 equal to 337.52 meters per second. The density of the gas at the exit, rho 2 equal to P2 by RT2, so 3.28 into 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 443 equal to 2.58 kilograms per meter cube. Mass flow rate for the new Mach number, M equal to rho 2 A2 C2, so which is 2.58 into 1 into 337.52 equal to 870.8 kilograms per second. So, answer to the problem, at M2 equal to 0.1, velocity is 44.37 meters per second and the mass flow rate is 156.63 kilograms per second. When the Mach number is 0.8, velocity is 337.52 meters per second and the mass flow rate is 870.6 kilograms per second. Example number 9, air enters the nozzle from a large reservoir at 7 bar and 320 degree Celsius. The exit pressure of the nozzle is 0.94 bar and the mass flow rate is 3500 kilograms per hour. Calculate the following, throat area, throat pressure, throat velocity, exit Mach number and the maximum velocity. So, this is from May 2014 question paper. So, the stagnation condition PO1 equal to PO2 equal to 7 bar, TO1 equal to TO2 equal to 320 degree Celsius, which is 593 Kelvin, P2 equal to 0.94 bar, mass flow rate equal to 3500 kilograms per hour, which is 0.972 kilograms per second. The pressure ratio at the exit P2 by PO2 equal to 0.94 divided by 7 equal to 0.134, isentropic table, from the isentropic table 3.2, page number 34. At the P2 by PO2 equal to 0.134 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take M2 equal to 1.97 and T2 by TO2 equal to 0.563. Again from isentropic table 3.2, page number 22, at the Mach number choking condition M star equal to 1 and gamma equal to 1.4, we have T star by TO equal to 0.834 and P star by PO equal to 0.528. Now pressure, temperature and velocity at the throat section. T star equal to 0.834 into TO equal to 0.834 into 593 equal to 494.56 Kelvin. P star equal to 0.528 into PO equal to 0.528 into 7 equal to 3.696 bar. C star equal to M star into square root of gamma R T star, which is 1 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 494.56 equal to 445.77 meters per second. Density of the gas at the throat section, rho star equal to P star by R into T star, 3.696 in 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 494.56 equal to 2.6 kilograms per meter cube. And calculating the area of the throat section, A star equal to mass flow rate divided by rho star into C star, which is 0.972 divided by 2.6 into 445.77 equal to 8.42 in 10 power 4, 10 power minus 4 meter square, which is 8.42 centimeter square. Temperature velocity at the throat section, so C2 equal to 0.563 into TO2, which is 0.563 into 593 equal to 333.86 Kelvin, and C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, which is 1.97 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 333.86 equal to 721.5 meters per second. The maximum possible velocity C maximum equal to square root of 2 Cp into TO, which is square root of 2 into 1005 into 593 equal to 1091.8 meters per second. The answer to the problem, throat area equal to 8.42 centimeter square, throat pressure equal to 3.696 bar, throat velocity is 445.77 meters per second, exit velocity is 721.5 meters per second, exit Mach number is 1.97 and maximum velocity is 1091.8 meters per second. Example number 10 from November 2014 question paper, ambient air with a stagnation condition PO equal to 1.013 bar and TO equal to 288 Kelvin is sucked by a blower through a convergent nozzle of throat diameter 10 cm. If the air velocity at the throat is reached by the sonic value, determine the pressure and temperature at the throat section, mass per head through the nozzle and the maximum velocity. So, we are given stagnation pressure is 1.013 bar and stagnation temperature is 288 Kelvin and the diameter of the throat section D star equal to 0.1 meter. From isentropic table, table number 3.2, page number 22, at M star equal to 1 and gamma equal to 1.4, sonic condition, T star by TO equal to 0.834, P star by PO equal to 0.528. Pressure, temperature and velocity at the throat section, T star equal to 0.834 into TO, which is 0.834 into 288 equal to 240.2 Kelvin, and the P star equal to 0.528 into PO, which is 0.528 into 1.013 equal to 0.535 bar, and the C star equal to M star into square root of gamma R T star, which is 1 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 240.2 equal to 310.66 meters per second. Density of the gas at the throat section, rho star equal to P star by R into T star, which is 0.535 in 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 240.2 equal to 0.776 kilograms per meter cube. So, the mass flow rate M equal to rho star A star C star equal to rho star into pi by 4 D star square into C star. Substituting 0.776 into 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square into 310.66 equal to 1.89 kilograms per second. The maximum possible velocity C maximum equal to square root of 2 Cp into TO, which is square root of 2 into 1005 into 288 equal to 760.84 meters per second. The answer to the problem, pressure and temperature at the throat section 0.535 bar and 240.2 Kelvin, mass flow rate through the nozzle 1.89 kilograms per second, and the maximum velocity is 760.84 meters per second. We stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find gas dynamics and jet propulsion book in the list. You can refer to the book for additional problem in the isentropic flow. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. We will continue with the problem solving in the next lecture also in the isentropic flow.